We should be able to see him around here somewhere. Excuse me. Have you seen a giant yellow bird around here anywhere? We were told that one lives here.
Yes, we've been looking all day.
Yes, well, that's Big Bird. He lives over there behind those doors.
We found him.
Oh, at last!
Shh, this is wonderful. Can I borrow your ladder?
Yes. Why do you want to borrow the ladder?
So we can see the bird over those doors. See, we're bird watchers. I'm Madeline, this is Cedric.
Yes, we love to watch birds and learn how they live.
Okay, I'll take you over there.
Is it?
Wow!
Oh, what do you see?
A very, very big bird. Write this down.
Oh, yes.
It's big and yellow.
Big and yellow.
It is sleeping in a giant nest.
Giant nest?
Wait. It's standing up. Oh, it must be 8 feet tall.
8 feet tall? Well, what kind of bird is it?
Well, it is certainly not a hummingbird.
I guess these people have never seen a bird like Big Bird before. I guess a lot of people haven't. Say, why are we whispering?
Shh. You'll frighten it, it'll fly away.
Don't worry. It can't fly.
And fly?
I can't believe this. The bird is pouring birdseed from a box into a bowl. That bird just made his own breakfast. Okay, what do we have so far?
Well, it's big and yellow. It sleeps in a giant nest, is 8 feet tall, can fly, and makes its own breakfast.
Uh-oh, it's playing jacks.
Playing jacks?
Wait, the Audubon Society hears about this. We have to get in closer so we can take his picture.
Yes, well, maybe if we crept up on the...
Wait a minute. I can save you a lot of trouble. Excuse me. Big Bird! Somebody wants to take your picture!
Oh, boy. Well, which side? My left side or my right side?
It talks.
Doesn't everyone?
Dressed up, all dandied and dressed up, all feathered and pressed up, and feeling so fine. Dressed up in our best formal design, outshine all the rest of you, aren't we divine? We beg your pardon, but fancy that you could be carefree and almost as happy as we see. How we're blessed with so much zest, with every button buttoned and every press pressed. We're dressed up, and aren't we the best?
11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Well, no!
Wonderful woods.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
and today our lesson is about our friend, the tree.
Ah. Wow.
Yes, now, first of all, this is a tree. And whoa, this part right here, this part of the tree, that thick part is called the stem.
No.
Well, it is not the stem. What is it called?
Well, my mommy says this is called the trunk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the trunk.
Right. Yep.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, I did not know the trunk. Okay, well, on the trunk, you say trunk. The trunk, there's a whole bunch of stuff on the trunk. That is called the skin.
No!
It is not called the skin. What is it called?
It's called the bark.
The mm-hmm. bark?
Yeah.
Huh. Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Uh-huh. See that thing up there, right up there?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, there's a whole bunch of those on the tree, and that is called the stick.
No!
That is not called the stick. Well, what is it called?
A branch.
Branch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, I know one thing for sure. One thing for absolute certain. All those little green things on the tree all over, they are the feathers.
No!
They are not the feathers, campers. Well, no. Campers, what are they?
The leaves!
Thank you!
You're welcome!
Campers, if that is true, then what is the next thing I'm going to describe? That part of the tree that is, well, it has fur and some claws and some teeth.
A bear!
Hey, come on. I want to hear more tree talk. Hey, could I be a camper too?
Gosh, I have to hurry. Oh, hi! I'm the letter N. You see me all the time in words like nail, nest, and net. Why, I'm right up front of words like notebook, needle, and noodle. Don't forget other N words such as nuts, napkins, and nose. But most of all, don't make noise at night. The letter N is nice. I like it.
Once again, it's time for Finger Theater.
friends.
Yeah! I'm your friend, you're my friend. I'm your friend, you're my friend. I'm your friend, so how do you do? I'm your friend, you're my friend. I'm your friend, you're my friend. I'm your friend, I'm fine. How are you?
Bored. Oh! Practice.
Sleep.
No. Sleep. Cooperate. Ah! Little more sleep, little more practice.
Practice and sleep. Yeah. Comfy?
Well, you all ready for our game?
Yes, sir.
Oh, what are you watching?
The bird is playing hide and seek.
I've just spotted a parrot in the fix-it shop.
Oh, okay. You cover the parrot, and I'll stay here.
All right.
Okay, I'm going to count to 20 now, and you all run and hide. Here I go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Anyone round my base is it?
Whoa! Oh. Can you say that again?
Oh, sure. Anyone round my base is it?
I mean before that.
Oh, the counting?
Yeah.
Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
The bird
11,
is counting.
12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Okay, can I just say one thing? Do you know that you are the first bird I have ever watched that can count to 20?
Really?
Yeah.
And do you know one thing? Do you know that you're it? Tag! Madeline's it! Let's all hide!
Thank you.
feeling is fine. Wouldn't it be fun for each one to go all the time? I wanna go, just come, get ready to swing. Come on and join the crowd, shout out loud, countin's really the thing. You have to stomp your feet, clap your hands, so come on, begin. We're gonna count and count till that great day. So lace up your shoes, throw away your blues. I wanna count, just count, it's so easy and free. Take a little bow, step up now, come on, count with me.
Hold the phone, stop the music! Stop the music, Cab Calloway. I did not know you were an aficionado of counting. You love to count?
I love to count.
I, too, love to count. Yes? That's why they call me the Count.
Oh, I see.
Yes, well, perhaps.
Suppose you do a little counting for me.
Yes, you can count on it. I thought maybe we could count together in the song.
All right, old dude, we'll do that.
And my friends can join us.
Right on.
You will count.
I want to count, just count, if the feeling is fine. Wouldn't it be fun for each one to count all the time?
I want to count, just count, get ready to swing. Come on, join the crowd, shout out loud, counting's really the thing.
Yeah! You have to stomp your feet and clap your hands, so come on, begin.
Yeah!
We're gonna count and count till that great day. So lace up your shoes, throw away your blues.
I wanna count, just count.
So
it's so easy to breathe. Take a little bow, step up now, come on, count with me. Oh yes, Cab, I would love to count your hit songs and the plays you've done in the films, but that would take forever, so please just dance.
Clap your hands. Come on, begin.
Yes, begin.
We're gonna count and count till that great day. So lace up your shoes, throw away your boots. I wanna count,
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 count.
It's so easy and free. I take a little bow, step up now.
Come on, count with me.
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Up.
Shout, shout, a day.
Wonderful! That's one terrific Cab Calloway!
Cups of oatmeal, 2 pitted mangoes.
Hey, Bert.
Buttermilk.
Bert, it's time for the rhyming game, Bert.
Oh, no, Ernie, thanks. I don't want to play a game. I'm reading my book.
Oh, but you'll love this game, Bert. See, all you have to do is you say something, and then I will say something that rhymes with what you just said.
Uh-huh, yeah, but I really don't want to play a game.
Maybe not, Bert, but we'll do it all the same. You see that? See, you said game, and I said same. And game and same both rhyme.
Rhyme, yeah, I know, mm-hmm. I know. But Ernie, it's just not what I want to do.
Wiggle your finger and waggle your shoe.
Ernie, I'd much rather sit and read my book.
With ears you hear and with eyes you look.
Now, come on, Ernie, cut this out.
Easy, old buddy, no need to shout.
I don't want to play a game with rhymes.
Nice going, Bert, oh, ring my chime.
I don't want to do it.
There's really nothing to it.
It's so silly.
A boy named Billy.
Stop it, please.
A dog has fleas.
Ow!
No.
Ernie, please, this has got to stop.
Some people like to jump and hop.
I don't want to do it.
No more.
Anymore.
What, hmm?
I want what? I don't want to do it anymore.
Oh, one and two and three and four.
Ernie!
Bernie!
Stop it!
Mop it!
Stop!
Flop!
No!
Blow!
Hippopotamus!
Ripatotopus.
All right. I give up.
Eat from a plate and drink from a cup.
I guess I'll just have to play along.
It plays like a game and sings like a song.
You may be right. I may be wrong.
The clock goes tick and a bell goes bong.
This game is really kind of kicking.
Sugar's sweet and glue is thick.
Hey, water is wet and dust is dry.
Dog's gotta walk and bird's gotta fly.
It's a great kind of game to play with a friend.
And now, old buddy, we've come to the end.
Yeah, you're right, Ernie. That's a great game. You.
Well, Bert, see, I think I'm gonna go read a book now, okay?
Hey there, lamp! That's a nice shade! You. It's not the same.
Roller skates, boy, you are sure talented.
Well, thanks, but aren't you getting a little tired of watching me?
No, I could do this all day.
Well, frankly, I'm getting a little tired of you watching me. Oh. So I wonder, maybe you could watch some other birds for a while, huh?
Other birds where?
Well, hey, gang, come here. Hey? This is Gummo, Zeppo, Curly, and Moe, the Canary Brothers.
Oh, how do you do?
Madeline, Canary Brothers.
Hi.
Canary Brothers, Madeline.
Very pleased to meet you.
You know, they can really sing. They can sing like canaries.
I can sing.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh.
I know. We could sing something together. Do you know the one about the brown bird in the cherry tree? What? What did they say?
They said if you hum a few bars, they can fake it.
Oh.
May I join you?
Yeah, well, let's all sing together.
Okay.
A brown bird whistled in a hollow tree when springtime was a-springing. I said, oh, birdie, will you please tell me what is that song you're singing? He said, I sing to birds and men in every kind of weather, that those who walk and those who fly can live in peace together, that those who walk and those who fly can live in peace together. That was good. The brown bear nestles in a hollow tree. A blackbird sings high over. The lark, the rabbit, and the bumblebee all share one field of clover. And some are born with hand or paw, and some with beak and feather. But those who walk and those who fly can live in peace together. Yes, those who walk and those who fly can live in peace together. Ha 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 ha
was nice.
That was great.
Mm. You know what? They enjoyed it, too.
I know.
That was fun, Tessie, my sweet.
Oh, yes, Thomas. I love roller skating.
Me too.
Well, it's time to go home.
Thomas?
Hmm?
Gracious to goodness me. We are inside. How do we get out?
Very good question, my dear. Let me see. I know. The wall. We'll go through the wall.
Yes. Yes, we will go through the wall. Who will go first?
I will go first. I will go first.
No, I'll go first. Here I go.
Try again. And this time, we'll try harder.
Okay, here we go.
That hurts.
That hurts.
Oh, that hurts.
Goodness to Betsy, yes.
However, are we to get outside? I know. We'll use the door.
The door.
Oh.
How clever you are, my dear.
We'll choose the
door. Here we go. One, two, three, jump!
Hey! We're outside!
The Little Letter L. A poem by Louise. I love the little L. It doesn't curve and swing in circles like some letters I could mention. It just stands there at attention. I love the letter L. Little L, you don't lean or lay below the line like Y does. Little L, you never get crossed like T's or dotted like I does. L, you're the little letter I wish I was. Little L.
Oh. Aha! How many children are there? Count them with the count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five children. Go! There they go. Ah, they're all in different places now. Now, how many children will there be? Let us count them again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and one little girl under the box. 5, still 5 children. Go, kids, yes. Oh, Sarah, oh, yes, good. Count them again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and under the box. 5, still 5 children. Yes, I counted you, you're 4. Go, kids, go. Yes. Oh, good girl. Now how many children? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No matter where they stand, there are still 5 children. Wonderful. I love it. Uh-oh. Bye-bye, kids.
Yes, that's right. No, I'll wait. Yes, I will. Thank you.
What's the special phone call you're making, Madeline?
I am calling the bird department of our government in Washington because I want to tell them about you and find out if you are an endangered species.
Oh, no. I could save you money. I'm not in danger. Why, whenever I cross the street, I always have a grown-up hold my hand, and I never run out from between the cars.
That's very good, but that is not what endangered species means.
Oh.
Big Bird, it's a bird or animal that there aren't that many left of.
Yeah, it means that there are hardly any other birds like you in the world.
You mean maybe I'm a rare bird?
Shh, I have the bird department in Washington.
McNulty, birds.
Hello, Mr. McNulty. This is Madeline. I would like to report another rare bird.
All right. What kind of bird is it this time?
Well, he's yellow. He lives on Sesame Street. He's 8 feet tall. He talks. He makes his own breakfast. He roller skates. He plays jacks and can count to 20.
Now, wait just a minute. An 8-foot bird that talks, makes his own breakfast, and counts to 20.
Yeah.
This is a joke, right?
No.
Next thing you're going to tell me, he knows the alphabet.
Do you know the alphabet?
Uh-huh.
You do?
Yeah.
I'm putting him on, okay? I'm putting the bird on the phone. Here.
Oh, Mr. McNulty?
That's McNulty.
Ah, okay. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
See, that's amazing. Can you say that again?
Oh, sure. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, OPQRSTUVWXYZ. And how about this? CAT cat.
That's amazing.
Okay, how about that, Mr. McNulty, huh? Now, is he an endangered species?
Is he? You bet. You take him to Windy Hill right away.
Okay.
That bird knew the alphabet. I need a vacation.
Congratulations!
Oh.
You are an endangered species.
Really?
Yep.
Hey, an endangered species. Did you hear that, friends? I'm an endangered species.
Congratulations!
Congratulations. Yeah.
So you better pack your things.
Why? Where am I going?
To a special place in the country for endangered species. The Windy Hill Bird Sanctuary, because you are rare, and we have to take special care of you.
Oh.
Can he stay here?
Does he have to go there?
Yes, he really should.
Big Bird?
Yeah, well, listen, folks, when you're an endangered species, there's some things you just gotta do.
That's right. That's a very brave bird, so come on.
Yeah, but could I bring my teddy bear?
You are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. The ladybugs came to the ladybug's picnic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And they all played games at the ladybug's picnic. They had 12 sacks, so they ransacked races. And they fell on the backs and they fell on the faces. Ladybug's 12 at the ladybug's picnic. They played jump rope, but the rope it broke. So they just sat around telling knock-knock jokes. The ladybug's 12 at the ladybug's picnic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And they chatted away at the ladybug's picnic. They talked about the high price, the furniture and rugs, and fire insurance for ladybugs. Ladybug's 12 at the ladybug's picnic.
12. L, L,
large. L, l, little, large, little, L.
Saxophone. Hey, John, John.
What?
You know the difference between up and down?
Up and down?
Yeah.
Oh, I think I know it. I know oh. I make it up and down.
Up is up there, huh?
Up and down.
And down.
Up
and down.
Up
and down.
Up and down.
Hey, that's good. You know that real well.
Say up and down.
Yeah, up and down. Thank you, John John.
You're welcome.
Give me five. For later.
Other side.
Yeah.
This is where us birds live, huh?
Yes. This is your new home in the country. You'll be very safe here, and you'll have lots of company. As you can hear, there's plenty of birds around.
Yeah, I can see them. There's some of my relatives up there, even.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, there's my Uncle Murgatroyd, my cousin Phyllis. Gee, but where's all the people?
Oh, no, there are no people here.
No people?
No, we don't have a sanctuary for them.
Oh. Well, then, where will I live?
Oh, don't worry about that, because you're going to have the house all your own. Do you want to pick it out now?
Well, I guess so.
Okay, well, here's a lovely big bird house.
Big?
Oh, for a bird house. How do you like it?
Well, I like the color.
Puce.
Oh, but I think it's a little too small for me.
Yeah. It does look a little snug, but don't worry, because here's an even bigger one.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, it is bigger, all right, but...
Yeah.
Well, what do you think, Radar? Radar thinks it's a little too small for me.
Uh-huh. Well, the bear is right, but
Don't worry about that, because here is the biggest one in the whole place.
Oh, this is the biggest one?
Yeah.
Well, maybe if I scrunch down, I could get in. Let me see.
Hey, flap off, tall stuff. This one's taken. All right, I'm coming, kiddies.
Well, I must say. Say, why don't you let me show you something in a tree? Would you like to build your nest inside this beauty?
Well, it's a nice tree, but how would I ever get up there? I can't fly.
That's why these steps are here. Do you want to climb up and take a look?
Well, okay.
How do you like it? A young bird with imagination could probably do a lot with this.
Yeah, well, there's lots of leaves up here, but I'm not sure these branches will hold me. I'll climb higher and see if they will.
Hey, big bird, watch out!
Uh-oh.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Oh. But, you know, I think I'm too heavy for a tree. And also, I don't like high places. But where will I live?
Well, if you don't like trees and you don't care for birdhouses, then, I know. Well, is there something that I could bring to you that would make you feel more at home here?
Yeah.
Okay, well, what would it be?
Well, you could bring me a building from Sesame Street and some old doors and make two walls on the outside and then bring my nest and put it inside the doors and then bring me Mr. Looper's door and Mr. Looper and Gordon and Susan and Maria and David and Olivia and Bob and a large city.
Do I get the feeling that you don't want to live here?
Yeah.
Well, I'll take you back to Sesame Street then.
You will?
Of course.
Yeah?
Yeah, I mean, this just is probably not your natural habitat.
No.
Yeah, I mean, you're probably really a city bird, see?
Yeah.
And birds have to live where they belong, so let's go.
Oh. You hear that, Radar? We're going home. Gee, just when I was beginning to like it here.
We're holding here, Jason. What do we call this thing?
Mirror with a hand on it.
A mirror with a hand on it. Mm-hmm. But it's certainly a mirror. And when I look in the mirror, I see me, Ernie.
No. I see me, Jason.
Well, no. I see me, Ernie.
No. I see Jason.
Oh, I see. Me, Ernie.
Jason.
Wait a minute. I'll tell you what we can do. If we put our heads real close together, we could see both of us. How about that? Yep. That's the best thing of all.
In an old and far off place, there was a lowercase n. Lonely and cold, she would face, and it was known that she would cry now and then. Lowercase n, standing on a hill. The wind is very still for the lowercase n. Then one day a rocket ship came racing from the sky. It landed on the hill and it opened up a door. Then something started coming outside.
Me, Alastair Cookie. Welcome to Monsterpiece Theater, home of classy drama. Tonight, me take you back to ancient Rome for big, big play. Me, Claudius.
Me, Claudius.
No, no, no. Me, Claudius.
What? Me, Claudius?
No, 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 no. Me, Claudius.
No. 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 Me, Claudius.
Me, Claudius.
No, me.
Me.
Me,
me, Claudius.
Me, Claudius.
Me, me, Claudius.
Me, Claudius.
And so end our drama. Me still not know who Claudius, but me, Alastair Cookie, saying good night for Monsterpiece Theater.
Endangered species. Handle with care.
We sure are glad you brought Big Bird back, Madeline.
Yeah, and we promise to take even better care of him because we know he's an endangered species. We've always known he was a special bird.
Aww. Well, he really is. In fact, there's probably no other bird like him in the whole world.
Oh, yeah, there is.
There is?
Oh, sure. This is my Auntie Maureen. Maureen lives in Chicago on the Loop. And she looks a lot like me, except she has blue eyes.
Are you getting this?
Yes, miss.
And then, let's see, there's my cousin Floyd, who lives in L.A. He looks a lot like me, except that he's purple, and he's a surfer.
Can we get a plane to Los Angeles?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, and then, of course, there's my Uncle Slim. He's a cowbird from Wyoming, but he's right here in New York right now.
What?
Oh, there he is. I'll call him for you. Oh. Hi, Uncle Slim! Hey, Uncle Slim, look, I'll meet you later at Birdseed Charlie's, okay?
Oh. Yet another biggie.
Wait a minute. Oh, Mr. Bird.
Mr. Bird.
Wait, oh, sir, excuse me.
Mr. Bird.
Excuse me.
Mr. Bird.
They sure like birds, don't they?
So do we, Big Bird.
Bye-bye, bird watchers.
Bye.
Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letters N for Nightingale and L for Lock. And the number 12. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Ha ha ha!